Let me ask you one simple question. What makes you keep going? It's a very big question, I know. It could be your friends, your family, video games, or all of the above. Life is weird and hard sometimes, but these things keep you going even if you don't always want to. They motivate you. Video games are no different. Sometimes they get boring or tiresome, and when that happens, you need something to motivate you, something to work towards. Some games use great story and world building to motivate, and some use constantly changing or improving mechanics. Today, we'll be talking about the latter. First, I am a giant Star Wars fan. I have seen all the movies, all the shows, and even read some of the books. Basically, I know a lot about Star Wars. So, when I heard Star Wars Squadrons was coming out, I was super excited. Even though I didn't necessarily like the genre it was in, the flying genre, I figured I'd still give it a shot. And oh, believe me, it delivered. But as I played the game, even before finishing the story or playing more than 5 or so online matches, I realized that this game has a giant skill curve. After playing for 15 or so more hours and finishing the campaign, I have barely scratched the surface of this skill curve. I still get my butt handed to me time and time again. Times than I care to admit. But that isn't the point. The point is, there is so much here to learn. Now, with most skill-based games, there is usually an equally competent progression system. After all, the progression is half the reason you keep playing the game. Right? For a game to make you want to play, at least from a mechanical standpoint, it has to have good gameplay to make you want to play moment to moment, a good short-term motivator, like winning a match, to keep you playing for a while, and finally, a good long-term motivator, like a progression system to keep you coming back. Without these, it will be hard for the player to have motivation to keep going, and the player will lose interest. Cough, cough, the new Battlefront 2. Anywho, Star Wars Squadrons uses various mechanics and ideas, including these three, to keep you wanting to play. Firstly, the basic gameplay is super unique. The flight genre itself is very niche. The fighting flight genre, even more so. But because it's so niche, it makes it feel so fresh compared to normal shooters. This also makes the game feel more fair, at least around launch, because everyone is learning even the basics. However, the game doesn't just completely leave you high and dry. The campaign is used as a tutorial for each ship and its basic techniques, while also serving as a competent and interesting story. So, the game at least gives you a fair chance. The team mechanic also adds to the diversity of the gameplay. Each person has a certain role to fill based on their ship. More on that later. This can lead to grandiose, complex strategies like bombing runs on ships or swift counterstrikes against the opposing fighters. Even if you aren't with friends, the game has a pinging system to allow some of this communication with randos. Even though it's up in the air if they'll actually pay attention to you or not. Back on track though, this really does allow for a lot of diverse gameplay. The second set of mechanics, which allows for this diversity, is the ship systems. Each ship has its own flight patterns, guns, upgrades, and tactics, even for the same ships on different sides. This essentially creates 8 different styles and learning curves to develop and master, giving the game so much more depth. Finally, there is the ship upgrade system. Each ship has more than 20 or so upgrades, which significantly impact how you play, and how you are able to react to situations. So, you could have a bomber, which is solely focused on taking lots of damage and taking care of enemy fighters, or you could have a bomber, which is super weak, but can deal massive damage to giant enemy capital ships. The quick rate of upgrades certainly ups the flow of the game too, making each match feel fulfilling and rewarding while having enough so you don't finish the game instantaneously. This allows the player to customize their ships and fulfill any role they want. Also, as a little bonus, each map is varied enough to allow different styles of gameplay, depending on your opponent and their strategy. The fact that some maps are easier to group up on than others creates a certain unique environment for each match. All of this creates a unique experience, which can very quickly engulf you. While I do think there is a couple problems, lower attention time after the novelty of the maps and game modes wear off, this can be easily fixed with updates, at least I hope so. All of this is to say, Star Wars Squadrons is a breath of fresh air for Star Wars and AAA games, and I definitely recommend this game if any of this sounds interesting to you. It has an actual great progression system, which allows for great diversity and creativity in the way you play. And in a time of what feels like restrictions and anxiety, some freedom and creativity can go a long way. Thank you guys so much for watching. I had a lot of fun with this video. Squadrons has been insane. Also, little fun fact, I think this is the first video I've done that's on like a brand new released game, so that's weird to think about. I've also wanted to cover more Star Wars for a super long time, so I'm finally able to do that. Not to mention, I might have some other things in the future. Anyway, on to the recommended channel. This week, I'm recommending Game Maker's Toolkit. I'm sorry, I know this isn't a small channel, but I genuinely looked, and I couldn't find any small channels which somewhat related to this topic. But he does. Anyway, he does amazing videos about the mechanics behind games, how they work in tandem with the themes and story of a game. I would definitely go check him out if you like that type of content or are just trying to make a game, because he gives quite a lot of tips and advice. Do you like Star Wars? Have you played Squadrons? What do you think of its progression system? Let me know the answers to these questions down in the comments below. If you enjoyed, leave a like, comment, subscribe for more pop culture and gaming content. Stay safe, stay healthy, and I'll talk to you all later. Goodbye, guys.